1, 2, 3, 4. Hey, y'all out there in Facebook world. What's up? What's up? What's up? We getting ready to go live real quick on WIGO. I just wanted to kind of touch base with my Facebook family a little bit and give y'all a little pre-introduction to Kwanzaa Griffin. She's an amazing woman. She's an entrepreneur. She's a woman out there doing her thing and getting her house along. So you guys will get a chance to meet her today on the show.
Now it's time for Donnie Jones Live, sponsored by Don's Tree Service. But it's not all about trees. It's a little bit of everything and then some. So sit back, relax, turn the radio up, and be a part of the show. This is WIGO, Atlanta's incredible radio.
Good morning, good morning, good morning. My name is Donnie, and welcome to Donnie Jones Live, where we come to you every week bringing to you great people in the community that are doing great things and making a difference out there, are basically out there getting a hustle on and doing what they need to do to make their life great, which is always an inspiration to me. And today on our show, we have a wonderful woman. Not only does she have a job with the CDC and making things happen, and she's a mom, she's an entrepreneur, which is the whole reason why I was like, we got to tell this woman's story, because she's out there doing it. Kwanzaa Griffin is her name, and I'd love for you all to meet her. Kwanzaa, tell us a little bit about yourself.
Hi, everyone, and thank you so much, Donnie, for having me here today. Happy May 1st.
Yes, happy May 1st.
Spring is for new beginnings, so I'm really glad to be here. A little bit about myself. Where do I start? So I am a mom.
Start at the beginning. No, I'm just kidding.
I was born in 19. No. I'm just kidding. I won't go there. I'm a mom of two. Kyla, who is 4. Christopher, who is 2. I am currently separated. And I guess I'll jump into a little background about my business.
Yeah. Well, we can learn a little bit about you. Okay. I did want to bring her on the show because, as I said, she's an entrepreneur. And I met her through a good friend of mine who we were doing an event with on June 9th. Yes. I've talked to you guys a little bit about this, but a pink affair is coming up, y'all.
Yes.
Get your tickets.
I will be
there. A pink affair. Kwanzaa's going to be there. Uh-huh. We're going to talk a little bit about what she's going to be doing there. But she's going to be at the event June 9th with Dolls to Divas. The name of the event is called A Pink Affair. Yes. And she is going to have her photo booths there. That's what she does, y'all. Yes. And so tell us a little bit about how you got into that.
Okay.
And everything.
Very good. So as Donnie mentioned, I work for the federal government. I've been there a little over 15 years. And as I would talk to some of my colleagues and my friends, everyone had a side hustle.
Right.
Everyone was doing their thing, entrepreneurs. They had their main job, but they also had another way to make money. So if something went down, guess what? Their main job wasn't, they weren't dependent on their main job. They had another source of income. And I didn't. And I feel like, well, why don't I have something? What skills
like,
do
what's
I
my
have?
Thing that
exactly.
I can do?
Exactly. Right. What is my thing? So in raising two small kids, I felt that I needed an additional source of income.
Yes. Yeah.
But in my mind, I had no idea what I could do. So what I did, what do we all do? We pray. I prayed December 2016. I said, Lord, I want to do something. I want a side hustle. Can you please give me a lucrative, meaningful side hustle for 2017? I wrote it on a piece of paper. I wrote a scripture.
You wrote it down. You made it plain.
Yes, I made it plain. And guess what? I didn't even realize I was doing something scriptural. I just did it.
Right.
So there's a scripture, John 10:10, that says, I come so that you have life and life more abundantly.
Exactly.
Yes, absolutely.
Yes.
And I wrote it down. I have abundant life. I have an abundant side hustle for 2017. I said it every single day, every time I saw that piece of paper. And one day, he gave me the vision. He said, photography. And I was like, photography?
Now, did you have a background in photography?
I do not have a background in photography.
Get out of here.
I had no thought. I mean, I like photography.
Right.
I do photo shoots for myself all the time. I've worked with some of the top names in photography for my maternity shoots. But I didn't think I would want to do photography. Right, right. So that was very odd to me.
Yeah.
However, I took it because it came from God. And if it comes from God, it's where
there
it's
you
at,
go.
Okay.
There you go. Absolutely.
So I signed up for some courses. And from there, it's just been taking off. And I'm still, you know, photography is an art. So it's not something you can just take one class and be
an expert. Exactly. And
you
I think it's funny you mentioned that because I think a lot of people, they have an idea for something.
Mm-hmm.
And then they're like, okay, well, I'm just going to go do it. And they don't realize the work that it takes to get good at it.
Exactly.
I mean, I love to listen to, like, motivational stuff, like, on YouTube. And Will Smith has this thing where he's talking about, you know, you could be given talent, mm-hmm. but without skill,
right?
You know, it's for naught. Because talent is great, but mm-hmm. you got to be skilled at your talent.
Exactly.
So that was beautiful that you realized that you had to work on your craft.
Exactly.
Now, once you decided to get your business started, what were some of the challenges that you ran into with getting your photo booth business going?
So some of the challenges was, of course, finding customers. You know, I'm new. So the first thing people will say, well, how long have you been doing
right,
it?
Right, right.
And do I say, oh, 2 weeks?
Right, right.
Or do I say, well, let me, because ultimately, you know, you can kind of fudge it a little bit because I have been taking pictures. I've been into photography for a while, but just not in a professional way.
So
getting customers. And so one of the ways that I overcame that challenge is by just putting myself out there, charging a lower price. And some people will say, don't do that. Some entrepreneurs say, no, your time is worth money.
Okay, can I speak to that?
Yes.
Your time is worth money.
Yes.
But at the same token, big companies do it too. And sometimes we just got to duplicate what's working.
Right.
Sometimes you got to charge a smaller price or a lower price
absolutely.
To get your foot in the door
to
build a foundation.
Right.
You know, I know that even now we're an established business, but if I know that I feel good about a customer and they're getting a few estimates, I might go ahead and go in on a lower price just so I get my foot in the door, and I'll let them know up front, like, listen, my normal price is this, but I want to build a relationship with you.
Right.
So do you feel like that has served you, or do
that's
you feel like...
absolutely has been so beneficial to me. I remember there was a Doubletree that was doing a grand opening, I think somewhere in Chamblee.
Yeah.
And I just heard about it, and I called them. I said, hey, I got a photo booth. Let me get in, because they were going to have vendors there, other hotel companies
is
there.
Is it the one off of Chamblee Dunwoody Road?
I
the Double
think
Tree
so.
Right off the highway?
Yeah, it is. Yes.
That's
that is
where
the
event is.
Oh, it's going to be at the same
yes,
place.
Yes, because they just had a remodel.
Oh, wow.
And they reopened, I think, last year. Is that when they had you?
Yes, I was there last year. Yep, they just, I was there. See how
you can't even make
circle.
This stuff. You can't.
Yes.
I didn't even know that.
I didn't know. That is amazing. That
oh
is
my
amazing.
Goodness.
And I'm trying to see if Tanya, I don't know if Dawson B was there or not. But anywho, so I did this event for free, and it was just amazing. I met so many different people, made so many different contacts. And from that event and maybe a couple of other events that I didn't charge, number one, I can now say Doubletree was my client.
There
you know, that's a big
thank
name,
you.
Okay?
Exactly.
Right.
When you walk in the door, you could be like, the Doubletree is my
absolutely.
Client.
Absolutely. I got permission to use their logo and their name on marketing materials.
That's right.
So, and then from
so
there.
So you're building your brand.
I'm building my brand.
Yes.
Absolutely.
That's
absolutely.
Awesome.
And from there, it has just shot off. So I've done baby showers. One of my big clients has been the University of Georgia. Thank you, University of Georgia.
Whoa.
Did
you go to, you went to school with Tanya?
We both graduated
from
UGA, but I did not know her at that
point. Dogs.
Right. Go dogs. Go dogs. So where was I going? So anywho, UGA has been a big client, some other universities. So basically it's just smooth sailing,
That's awesome.
No complaints. And you know, and you know, with the photography, I take pictures.
Yeah.
It's not perfect. I don't charge a lot of money. Some are really, really good. Some are not so good,
right.
But it's a learning process. I'm still taking courses.
Now we're going to have a lesson right now.
Yes.
Real quick.
Do it.
Don't say you don't charge a lot of money. Just say you're reasonable.
I'm very reasonable.
You're reasonable.
I'm reasonable. Absolutely.
Because you know how people take advantage of that. They be like, oh, well, I'm going to call her because she don't charge a lot of money.
Right.
And people don't know exactly what that means. And they be trying to come to you sideways.
And like, I will say, me saying I don't charge a lot of money to somebody else may be a lot of money.
Right,
so
right,
reasonable
exactly.
is a
you're
good
reasonable.
Way to,
yeah,
that's
you're
a good way
reasonable.
To present it. Absolutely.
But what I liked about it is it made me think of, when you started talking about your side hustle, it made me think about something Steve Harvey has said.
Mm-hmm.
He said a lot of people are missing their calling because they think that's something that comes natural to them or a word that God gave them is like, how can I do it? And so right. they miss it, you mm-hmm. know,
right.
as opposed to pursuing it.
Right.
Where, and he also talked about you should always have a side hustle.
Always.
Like, you should always have something that you do that you get good at and you can make money at.
Right, absolutely.
You know, because even though you're with a stable institution like the CDC, mm-hmm. you never know what could happen.
You never know. You that's know? Right. That's
and
right.
In fact, there was a government... was it like a shutdown?
Yeah. Yes, absolutely.
But I right. felt it was a little bit more comfortable for you because you were like, that's just more time for me to do
exactly,
my business.
Exactly. So, yeah. That's exactly it.
So yeah. how do you juggle being a mom and having a business and having a regular full-time job? How do you juggle that?
Yeah, it's not easy at yeah. all. So one thing that I didn't mention to you is that I'm recently separated as well.
Yeah.
So being a single mom, too small, very active, very happy, semi-spoiled kids. it's a lot of work.
Yes.
But I make it happen.
You
I
make
do the best
happen.
That I can.
As moms, we do what we got to do.
We do what we got to do.
We got to do to
exactly.
make it happen.
Exactly.
That's awesome.
And I will say, you know, sometimes it's a little slow. So the start of this year has been a little rough
right.
just with being a single mom, dealing with some things, going through a divorce. But God will make a way because
yes.
I'm already booked for June.
Go on,
three
girl.
Gigs that I did not really push
yes.
the market myself to
yes.
have. But, you know, they because of my working with different people, getting
yeah.
quality service, people
yes.
are coming to me.
People are coming to
me
you.
Without me having
that's
to
right.
do anything. So.
And once again, let's tell the people how they can get in contact with you real quick.
Yes, that's wonderful. So my company's name is Griffin Treasures by Q. So you can find me on Instagram.
Yes.
You can find me on Facebook. My email address is griffintreasuresbyq@gmail.com. And I'll give you my number as
yes,
well.
Yes, please do.
770-256-2800.
And once again, say that email again, and then we're going to take a break real quick, guys. Our mystery jam today, you know what? I ain't going to tell y'all what our mystery jam is. Those of you on Diet WIGO, y'all will hear it in a minute. Those of y'all on Facebook, we got to hook this media thing up so y'all can hear the music. But I know there's a thing nowadays with Facebook that if you play music or something like that, they'll pull your video down. I don't know. But anyway, once again, how do we get in contact with you? And then we'll take a break.
Yes. So Griffin Treasures by Q at gmail.com. And Griffin is GRIFFIN. And number 770-256-2800.
Go ahead. You was already playing?
No.
See, that's what I told you. I can't hear. I did. Exactly. But that's because I started talking. You know how I flow.
So how am I doing?
You are doing very
are you sure?
good.
Oh,
yes.
Okay.
You
right.
are doing
all
very,
right.
very,
okay.
very, very,
okay.
good.
Very good.
I'm
very good.
That
okay.
very good. And I meant to mention, because I gotta look at some trees here,
mm-hmm.
because the tower went down last Tuesday, but we're still streaming
okay.
live. So people that are I guess on the internet that listen to the
okay.
show.
Okay.
He told me not to.
Yeah, put the, it's the same. Nothing changed.
Well, I ain't gonna put them on now because we already started the Facebook live feed without it.
Okay, but I'm saying once you go back on the air,
mm-hmm.
nothing changed. You use your headset.
Okay. Are you sure, Marty? Because Marty told me not to. You told me not to use the headset.
No, so far as hearing, everything's still the same.
For hearing purposes, you can put it on. What I was talking about was doing the same thing over again. But you was just going out with the music. Ain't a big thing. Keep in mind, you're still streaming.
Okay. Yeah. Oh, goodness. We are still streaming. Hello, y'all. Hello. But, you know, some of y'all ain't chimed in today. So I don't know what's going on with my Facebook live feed. Maybe it ain't showing up. Because I usually have my little people up there and I don't see y'all. That's okay, because you know what? I rebroadcast this. So at some time today, y'all going to see me. What would you like the people to know about you, Kwanzaa, that we haven't talked about yet?
Before we
come back on to WIGO.
Well, what I want people to know in general is, as long as you have that servant mindset, so being a
yeah.
servant leader, things will come to you.
That's right.
So there are so many other ventures that I have going on right now in which I'm serving, giving back to my community, and the Lord has blessed me.
That's awesome.
So that's just a word that I want to just share, and maybe
yes.
we can bring that up as well.
I want to bring
servant
that up. Look
leader.
At you. You do need your own show going.
Okay. So that is my philosophy. Serving, yes. Being a leader in your community through serving.
That's
so,
right.
And not to say I want recognition or I need the recognition, but I'm so thankful that you have me on your show so I can share my story with others and hopefully motivate others to do things.
Well, when Tanya told me about you, because I told her who I was trying to attract to the show, mm-hmm. which are people that, you know, have something to give. And they do use their life to serve others mm-hmm. and that are inspirational. And the thing is, I wanted to get away from everybody. I mean, I love Oprah. That's my girl. Okay. Right, and she's one of my inspirations. Mm-hmm. But a lot of the people that she has on the show, well, almost everybody she has on the show is somebody that's achieved this XYZ. Mm-hmm. Whereas we forget that there's what I like to call everyday heroes. There's people out in the community, such as Kwanzaa, that are out there making their dreams come true. And to me, that's inspirational.
Right. Absolutely.
You know, like I can see, touch, and feel this person right. that is out there doing it. And so for me, I feel like your story needs to be shared
right.
as well as other people out there because it takes a village.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean?
Absolutely.
It really does. Mm-hmm. Like you're able to serve in a way that maybe somebody else isn't mm-hmm. able to serve just because of where your heart is.
Right.
You know?
Right.
So just using your gift. So guys, if you know of anybody else in the community that is doing great things, we're building the show. We want to make sure that we get people the word out about people, but we're going to go back live on WIGO AM. You guys can always stream us. Welcome back to the show, guys. We appreciate you being with us, and I am early. See, but y'all didn't see that. Hello, hello, hello again. We're live again with Kwanzaa Griffin. She's the owner of a Facebook, a photo booth company. And Kwanzaa, tell the people again the name of your company and how to get in contact with you yes. one more time.
Okay, thank you, Donnie. So the name of my company is Griffin Treasures by Q. You can find me on Instagram and Facebook at Griffin Treasures by Q.
Yes.
Email address, griffintreasuresbyq@gmail.com.
Exactly. And for the people that don't know what it means, we all been to parties and we know what a photo booth is, uh-huh. but just kind of talk to the people real quickly about what it is you do when you come to an event or basically from A to Z what you do
for a party
or an event.
Okay, so typically when you have an event, you maybe want to give out a favor, and sometimes you got to pay all this extra money, wrap it up, hand it to people. But with the photo booth, all you do is have me come. I set up in a corner. I have a tent or not. I have a backdrop. I have trinkets and things like that that you can use to put in your pictures. And basically people come, they take their picture, the pictures go directly to their cell phones.
Yes.
So people like using a photo booth instead of purchasing trinkets to give out because it's easy. They can upload it to Facebook, to all of their social media.
That's right.
So it's just a really cool way, and it's fun, it's cute. You can do it for baby showers, parties, graduations, whatever.
That's right. That's awesome. And guys, once again, the reason why we had Kwanzaa on the show is because I'm excited about her business. I love the fact that she took something, like she took a word from God. I mean, mm-hmm. tell the people again, basically, I will tell the people again, mm-hmm. you basically prayed for an opportunity.
Right, right.
You got a word from God and you acted on it.
And
you know?
I acted on it, absolutely.
How did you know that was, like when you prayed about this and he said photography, what was the first thing that went through your head? Like what?
Right,
like,
it was like photography, because that's not, you know, I have a degree in policy, in valuation. Yeah. So I thought he was going to say, oh, go back to teaching, because I taught a little while. But and I said, oh, that was odd.
Yeah.
But I knew it was from God because it was so odd. It was so unlike what I thought I should be doing.
Right.
And so I knew it was God, and it just came out the blue. I don't even know if it was a dream or if I was just sitting there minding my business, and he just said, do photography.
Right. But you went with it. That's
And I went with it, and that photography has led me down so many wonderful opportunities.
Yes.
I've worked with Steve Harvey. I've worked with Derek Blanks. I've just done so many different things.
Yes.
Because I listened to God, and now I have this booming photo booth business.
That's
and
awesome.
Which, when I will say, when I started the photo booth portion of the photography, I was told, oh, that market is saturated. You're not going to be able to get a lot of business. Yeah. And it is. There are
okay,
a lot
see,
of people.
Okay, see, I didn't know that. I didn't
There
know
are a
that.
Lot of people with photo booth businesses, but it has not affected me.
Right, right.
So it may affect a lot of other people, but I have been very blessed with business opportunities.
But, you know, people say that to me about tree service. They're like, oh, there's a ton of tree services out there.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I tell them? But there's only one Donnie.
Okay.
So, you know,
all right.
There's only one Kwanzaa.
Exactly.
And the thing is, guys, if we get out of the mentality that there's not enough, to go around, we got to get out of that scarcity mentality.
Right, absolutely.
And also believe that
we have a place in this world.
Right.
We have a place in business, you know. And I think for a lot of people, they feel like, well, how am I going to fit in, mm-hmm. you know?
Right.
You sometimes you got to kick the door down and make yourself fit right. in, you know?
And especially when you're doing something that's the will of God for your life. So yes. if you prayed about something, God has revealed it to you.
Yes.
You go for it. Yes. Not necessarily if you're just trying to run behind what you see other people doing.
Oh, that's
but
so good.
What God's will is for your life, that's yes. what you do.
That's right.
right. Absolutely.
You obviously have a very strong spiritual foundation. Where did that come from? Because I can hear it all over everything you say.
And, you know, I don't know. I will say for my mom. So my mom, Irma Brooks, I love her
to death.
Give
mom a shout out.
Right, mom a shout out. I grew up in a very small church, Mount Tabor Baptist Church on the west side across from Morehouse. It's a small storefront church that I love. I still go back to this day. So I think just my growing up and how I was raised, yeah. I just always kind of go back to the word of God and, yeah. and lean on him when yeah. needed.
That's right. Lean on him yep. when needed. And mm-hmm. believe me, we all need him.
Right, absolutely.
So what are some things that you're going to be doing in the future? I know you mentioned you got some other projects, some other things that you're excited about. Mm-hmm. You want to tell the people a little bit about what you're doing?
Yeah, so what's going on? So I have a few events coming up in June. I have a... UGA has just called me, so we're having a young alumni event.
Nice.
Right? And then we have the Dawes, the Diva, the Pink Affair
yes,
event
coming
up. Yes,
a Pink Affair, guys. We yes. really want you guys to be ladies. Grab your daughters, your nieces,
Absolutely.
Your grandma, and come check out a Pink Affair. Because
right.
it's going to be an event to remember, and that is June 9th. So please mark that date on your calendar.
Right.
And Quan's is going to be there.
I will be there with the photo booth. Come check me out. It's going to be really, really nice.
Exactly. Now, for people such as yourself that and once again, we're speaking with Kwanzaa Griffin. And I keep messing up the name of her company, so I'm going to let her say it every time I say
yes,
it.
Yes, Griffin Treasures by Q. And let me just tell you a quick background about why I chose that name, which sometimes I'm like, is that the best name? But basically, I had so many ideas. So with the photography, with the photo booth, yeah. I was starting an online store. And I said, you know what? If I do one name that encompasses everything.
Griffin Treasures.
Griffin Treasures.
Okay, I can't forget it now.
Right. So that's why I came up with that name. But sometimes it's a little much to say sometimes.
Yeah, Griffin Treasures. Right. I just know her as Kwanzaa. Right. I mean, like Kwanzaa the photo booth lady. Kwanzaa the
right,
photo booth
basically,
lady. But
basically.
You know what? I love that because you're not just thinking just one stream of income.
Absolutely. Right.
You know? And that's also a bit biblical, guys. More than one stream, but that's a whole nother show. Mm-hmm. What would you say when you do meet people that mm-hmm. say they can't do what you've done? Mm-hmm. Meaning they don't, like, how am I going to get started when I don't have the money to get started? Mm-hmm. When you look at somebody like yourself mm-hmm. that's living your dreams, that's pursuing what you call your side hustle, but to me it's just a business.
Right.
That's
right.
what it is. But that's what your side hustle is. It's a
right,
business
it's
that
a business.
Putting income in your pocket, but you got to run it like a business. And this woman runs it like a business. Mm-hmm. What would be some advice that you would give a young entrepreneur or an old entrepreneur? Because, you know, we're
okay,
over
hey.
40 now.
Hey, hello.
Over 40. Mm-hmm. That's like, I don't know if I could do this. What would you say to them?
I couldn't do it. So when I received the word from God, I did not think I could do it. Where am I supposed yeah. to get this money to buy?
Yes.
Number one, the tent cost $600. The iPad that I used was like $800. I mean, it was a lot of money, yeah. very expensive. However, like I mentioned earlier, when yeah. it comes from God, God would make a way.
He make a way.
It
he
will
don't
happen.
Give you the vision without
okay.
the provision.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely. So things will happen. You just keep pushing forward. You start working on it. If you had to buy some materials, you can't buy it in that moment. You can do your marketing plan.
Yes.
You can start making contacts. You can educate yourself by taking classes, going on YouTube.
Yes.
You can do something to start building your brain before you actually yes. purchase something if you have to do that.
So, I did the same yeah, thing. I always right. tell people it's my $43, $41 on a dream story.
Oh, I love it.
Basically, I didn't have money, but I was like, I can get some business cards.
Yes.
And that's how I started.
Business cards like $5.
Well, exactly.
That's what I did. I did the same thing. Yes,
yeah.
absolutely. Yep.
So we're living this stuff, guys.
Yep.
This isn't theory. We're not saying something we're thinking about doing. She owns this business.
Right.
I own my own business. And my goal is to be able to use people's stories such as Kwanzaa's to inspire you to do your own thing or to pursue your dream. Your dream might not be, you know, a business. Your dream might be to go back to school.
Right.
You know,
absolutely.
Or to overcome adversity.
Right.
You know,
right.
and with mm-hmm. faith, all things are possible. You know, it really is mm-hmm. true. And I want to thank you for coming on the show.
Thank you,
I mean,
Donnie.
Seriously,
thank you.
It really means a lot. You mm-hmm. know, what do you see? I know we talked a little bit about what you see in the future for yourself. Is there anything right now today that you want to tell the people about, aside from things that are going on in the future that you want to share?
Yeah, so and we kind of chatted about this before we came back. It's just that my philosophy, so my leadership philosophy is being a servant leader. So, you know, and sometimes people think, well, you know, a servant, that's not really a leader. I want to lead. I don't want to serve someone. You know, I don't want to watch someone
speak. She's getting ready to preach, y'all.
But, you know, being a servant leader is how you excel. So, and that's really how you be a leader. So when you leave this earth, people will remember what you did for the community. What did you leave from behind with the community?
That's right.
So beyond me making money off this very great photo booth business and photography business, I'm doing other things. I'm trying to mentor young girls. I'm starting a mentorship organization. I just started working on something that's completely out of my range, but I'm working on starting a community garden. There are there's an apartment complex, low income, Indicator, Georgia. They have this large plot of land that's not being used. And guess what we're doing? We're going to start a community garden. I just had a meeting with the management last week. We have some folks coming out to test the soil this week.
Wow.
And this is going to be done because I want to serve. I want to give back.
Yes,
and
yes.
God is making it happen. I don't have to come out of my pocket. People are going to give me money to do
it. That's right.
And so basically, serve the community you live in. Leave something behind. So when you leave this world, they can say, oh, this person left this. This person did that.
Yes.
And that's how you be a leader. That's how your name is attached to that leadership role.
That's right. You got to serve.
Right. Absolutely.
I love what you just
said. Make that your goal to serve and to give back.
You know what? If we focus on serving, it comes.
Yes.
Whether it's opportunity, whether it's money,
right,
whether it's vision. If you just get into the mindset, I want to use my life to serve others.
Right.
It really does come. Like us meeting.
Yes.
You know? And
we've
been trying to do this for like a month.
Absolutely.
I know she's been busy and y'all know I'm so last minute. I'd be like, oh, can you come down? She's like, wait a minute. We got to schedule this stuff out. But the thing is, guys, that's helping me work on myself to become a better servant. And everything that happens in your life is for your benefit in some way, shape, or form, even if it doesn't look like it right now.
Right.
You know?
Absolutely.
And if we can use those life lessons to serve others and to
plant seeds.
And plant
those
seeds. Yeah.
Yep.
Man, we all over trees today, but
okay.
Planting seeds,
okay.
Gardening.
Right.
I'm telling you, it's like it's all in the atmosphere.
Right.
Well, Kwanzaa, I want to thank you again.
Thank you.
For coming on the show. It really means a lot. And
thank you.
It's funny because you went back to what I was trying to say. I lost it for a minute, but I was like, there was something she said on the break, and you picked right up on it. It was about serving others.
Right, absolutely.
And using your life to do so.
Absolutely.
Once again, tell the people how they can get in touch with you, and then we'll be ready to rock and roll and get out of here.
All right. So again, Kwanzaa Griffin, Griffin Treasures by Q. You can find me on Instagram, Facebook, email address, griffintreasuresbyq@gmail.com, and my phone number is 770-256-2800. Give me a call.
Awesome. You guys, that's our show for today. Once again, thank you, Kwanzaa Griffin.
Thank you. Thank you for
and
having
me. I'm so thankful that we got a chance to meet. And I got a feeling we're going to be doing some stuff together in the future.
Yes.
So
hopefully I can come back.
Yes, you can.
Yay.
And you guys, I do have a show that I shoot on location where I go out and I meet people at their businesses or while they're out in the community.
Mm-hmm.
Or they'll come back to my little fabulous home and hang out with us. We're going to do that too. And I would love for you to be on that show.
Wonderful.
Also.
Wonderful.
Absolutely. So you guys have an amazing day. Enjoy your life. Go out there and make a difference and be committed to serving others. God bless you.
God bless you. Bye-bye.